Oi. What is all this stuff? Got her plugged in.
Well, she's been plugged in for a couple hours now. Our overhead display, our radio, been kind of spazzing out here. She should start right up since she was plugged in. Oh yeah. Oh, pressure seems to take a few seconds.
Valve high idle mod. Reach of the seat there.
What is up, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Today we got something a little bit different. We have been just busting butt on the race truck for the longest time now, and you guys haven't really been able to see the 12 valve recently. So we got some things we're going to be doing to the 12 valve, some updates on that thing. As far as the race truck goes, we are still waiting on those quick connect fittings for the fuel system, and we still need to get a starter and coolant. So we are super close on this truck here. I'm hoping next weekend, that video, you guys will probably be seeing this thing getting started and running. We've been slowly draining the oil or putting the oil in the truck, so we're super, super close. But today's video is not about the race truck. Today's video is about the 385,000-mile daily driver 12 valve. So as you guys know, this is the daily driver. Check out what we did. We went ahead and painted all of our valve cover pieces here. We painted the turbo housing, the pipe that comes off of the turbo right there. We painted that. We painted our intake piece here. We have just been cleaning the heck out of this thing and making it look really, really good. So the paint actually turned out super good. It's the same paint that I used here for the red on top there. So we have new bolts to get rid of these parts, the two studs that are in the front and the back that used to be holding that piece there. So we have new ones for that, and then we also have new valve cover seals as well, so that we can go ahead and get that taken care of, because they are, after I painted these, it is leaking a little bit. So we have new valve cover gaskets for that too. So this beautiful truck here behind me more recently has been giving us a little bit of problems, mainly the transmission. The engine has been doing absolutely fantastic, but the transmission has been giving me problems. We installed a DNR Customs TPS delete because the TPS had gone out, which first started the transmission issue, so we did that. And then that solved my problem for a little while, and then we ran into the torque converter was not locking at all. So we installed a lockup switch. So I'm going to kind of go over some of that stuff, and that combination seems to be working out the best for me at the moment. But very soon, maybe this spring, we might be getting the transmission built in this thing. We really need to make it to spring. So that's the kind of a small update. We're going to get to ripping these valve covers off and get the new seals on and get those two new bolts in. So stay tuned.
So these are the two bolts we're going to be replacing right here. This is what we're going to be replacing them with. This replaces those two studs, like I said, that had that long cover that went over the top. Well, now we can get rid of that. That'll clean it up a little bit. These are the valve cover seals. It also comes with the seal for that little bolt as well. So that's what we're going to be using there. And this is the part number for the replacement bolts too. I literally like this. This is going to clean it up a lot, doing these bolts and stuff like that. So we'll go ahead and get these going and catch up with you guys soon. Just like that, we are all the way back together. You can see how much nicer this looks without those studs on there. We are gonna clean that up a little bit. We have a little bit of oil that had leaked prior to replacing these seals. We gotta clean that up and stuff. But basically, you know, if these have never been replaced before, these are extremely brittle and they crack and eventually just deteriorate themselves. So those ones were much, much nicer compared to these. Like I said, we also replaced the seal on the bolt as well. When I painted these, I went through and adjusted all of the valves as well. So all of those are back into spec and she is looking really, really good. We are going to be replacing the radiator soon because it does leak a little bit. I don't think that's all from the radiator there, but I did find just a couple days ago that the radiator is leaking a little bit, so we are going to address that.
So really, other than that stuff, we also replaced the starter on this truck as well, but I honestly think it may have just been a wiring issue from the starter, but either way, you know, having a brand new starter in there with a lifetime warranty in my name is really beneficial. So really happy about that, really happy about the way this thing has turned out. Looks really good. Like I said, the radiator, we need to do that next. It doesn't leak really bad, no big deal. But I'm happy the block heater works because we have a really, really cold week ahead of us. So very happy that that works. Real quick, guys, I'm going to go over the torque inverter lockup switch, and the delete that we did, the APBS delete. So let's jump into that.
So right there is your APPS, your throttle position sensor. So all you got to do to install this APPS delete is you unplug it, you follow the directions, and you plug your wiring harness that they provide into your connector, which you can see there. And then we ran it into our cab like so. Inside of the truck here, you can see we positioned it right here. It took me a little while to put this in position of where I wanted the overdrive to kick in, but basically what DNR Custom says to do is rev it up to where you want it to shift into overdrive, go through your gears, get it to where you want it to shift into overdrive, and then dial that in. They do suggest starting about a quarter of a turn back, and that's basically what I did. I think I moved it maybe a little bit further than just a quarter, but I have it positioned perfectly right where I want it. So let's go look at the torque inverter lockup switch. So for the torque inverter lockup switch, you can see our PCM over there. We took that noise isolator out first, and then I believe it's pin 54. It's a black and pink wire, I believe, and you tap into that wire. You split into it. You do not cut the wire. You just split into it, kind of tee into it, and then you can see I ran my wire clear across the header panel there. We ran that into the cab to a switch, right? An on-off switch, a simple on-off switch, and then we ran the other end, so we put a spade connector on it, ran it to the top of the switch, and then on the bottom side of the switch off another spade connector, we ran that back out of the cab. We ran it right here directly to the battery, and basically all we're doing is we're giving the torque converter solenoid a ground, so that we manually end up locking up the torque converter. For some reason, our PCM is not doing it for us like it should. It could be a trans temp sensor. It could be the solenoid itself. It could be a bad ground. As you can see, we've replaced all of our battery connections and stuff. So we've gone through and tried to do everything we're supposed to. I just think that the torque converter is actually going out.
So like I mentioned, soon, probably in the spring when we're daily driving this thing, maybe we can rip the transmission out of this thing, see what's going on with that, and see if we can't maybe even just go ahead and build this thing. And then from there, then we can really have some fun with this thing, start doing injectors and turbos and manifolds and just some really, really fun stuff. So I'm super pumped. I'm super excited. Sometimes things just happen and you have to be forced to have upgrades. But sometimes that's not always a bad thing. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this little video, a little bit of an update and some work on the 12 valve. The engine bay looking killer. She's doing fantastic. besides just regular maintenance type stuff and a few things here and there. 380,000 miles. I mean, there's going to be some stuff. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure you like, subscribe. The race truck is going to be running this weekend. We are going to have those fuel quick connect fittings. So stay tuned. Subscribe, like, leave a comment down below. Catch you guys in the next video. Peace.